I really wanted to do this earlier, but my voice was like cracking up and my throat was hurting, but I'm actually feeling pretty okay now. So that's why on the last day of the year, I still wanted to do this stream. This game supports autosave. This game includes occasional beep plots when shocked or surprised. Please scream loudly and disturb your neighbors. To guarantee the best experience, please pick a dark night, make some hot coffee and have some tissues ready and put on your headphones. Then start your adventure. That's a nice beginning of a game. Why do I not hear sound?
Powering on.
I should put on my headset. I bought this game because it looked pretty good and I actually like visual novel style games. And it had some puzzle things in it, so I'm just going to try it. Autosave data exists. Starting a new game will override the autosave data. Continue. Yes. Suitable for players who are not familiar with this type of game, there will be hints giving red text to help you navigate through the levels. You may change the difficulty level at any time to challenge yourself. The door to a wonderful world is now open in front of you. We hope you enjoy your adventure. Suitable for players who have natural gifts in logic and deduction. Okay, so normal this. Because I'm an idiot in logic and deduction. There was an urban legend. Write your troubles down on a note. Hold it in your hand at midnight and pray. God, please help me. Then God will hear your plea and change your fate. It was only a legend though. That had gone viral for a brief period of time, except from modern urban legends. Art style so pretty. ... My head hurts. Where am I? What happened? You finally woke up. What's a doggo? I've been waiting for so long. I was beginning to worry that you might never wake up. Because I'm your biggest fiend. It's a talking dog. And are you? Hey, Acerno. Happy early new year. My pet? Must stay calm. Okay, so he's not my pet. How dare you call me a pet? Do I look like a pet? Well, yes. I am your servant, don't you remember? Servant? Servant? What is this talking dog going on about? Am I having a dream? Servant, as in you could help me fetch the newspaper? Have you lost your memories? Lost my memories? Yeah, you fell down the stairs yesterday. Then you passed out. I thought you might have hit your head. I fell? But my head doesn't hurt anywhere. There's no bruising. Anyway, let's both settle down a little. How about a quick test? Now, look into my big, beautiful eyes and tell me, what is my name? Fluffy? Fluffy my ass. Well, I guess you really did lose your memories. My name is Will. Sometimes I go by Willy. Willy? Yes, Willy. Willy Wonka? No, it's just Willy. I don't own a chocolate factory. Also, don't you know that chocolate is dangerous for dogs? Oh my god. It's already starting, like, hilariously. Oh, wait. I'm not a dog. Oh boy, it seems worse than I thought. Listen to me carefully. I'm not a dog, and you're not a human. That doesn't sound right. We are gods. What? Yeah, that's right. We are gods. How did you know what I was thinking just now? I'm a god. Of course I know. As gods, it's our job to change the fate of the humans who ask us for help. Humans encounter all kinds of trouble in their lives, and sometimes they pray to us, hoping for miracles, as they call them. We can help them and grant their wishes, or not. It's all up to you, of course. Wait, 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 stop blabbing so fast. I don't understand what you're saying at all. I'm not babbling, you're just too slow. You know what? Let's start with job orientation, shall we? Come over here, it's time to do some work. Hold on, are we starting already? I still don't have a clue on what's going on. Besides, didn't you just tell me that we're gods? Why do gods have to work? Don't lie to me just because I've lost my memories. I was not lying. In any case, if you don't finish today's work, we won't have any dinner tonight. Fine. Okay, this is very enjoyable. See that small red box? That is a message from a human today. Alright, let's see what she's got herself into this time. I want to go home. My name is Li Wen. I am a senior at Yinyan High School. Today I went to a nearby court to play tennis for the first time since I'd moved to my new place. It was a very poorly maintained court, so I guess hardly anyone ever uses it. The light over the tennis court is maintained by some of the residents themselves. The dim light bulb kept making a buzzing noise. 1, 2, 3. I had just hit all 30 balls that I had, so I picked up the now empty basket. I walked to the other side of the court and collected the balls before hitting them all again. No one else was on the tennis court. All I could hear was the sound of the balls hitting my racket and then bouncing off the ground. The light bulb flickered twice and went out. I picked up most of the balls and left the court, walking towards a small alley. I had walked through it earlier on my way to the court. The alley was always dark, no matter what time of day it was. I kept humming to myself quietly in my head, just to be less scared. I arrived at my apartment and suddenly realized that my keys were not in my pocket. I tried to think back. I must have left them at the tennis court. If the light hadn't suddenly gone out, I would have noticed that they were not on me. Well, this sucked. It was too late to go back to the court, not to mention that I might not even be able to find the keys with any light. A desk lamp was on in the manager's office, as was the radio, but nobody was in there. I stood outside the window and waited for a long time, but Uncle Sun, who was supposed to be on duty tonight, never showed up. The motion sensor lights in the hallway kept turning on and off every few minutes. I was beginning to feel a little scared. A late night talk show was on. The hosts were talking about a popular urban legend that had also been making the rounds at school. It said that if you wrote a note to... sorry. Seems my voice is still not totally back. Let's see how long I can keep this up. It said that if you wrote a note to God in the middle of the night, then God would solve all of your problems for you. Jing was really into this stuff. Well, if such a God really exists, maybe he or she could help unlock the door for me. Or make Uncle Sun come back to this office soon. Please, please, Li Wen. Yeah. Yeah, so the part that's really important is the red. Well, do people always write to cults just because they forgot the keys? Not always, no. But humans are exceptionally annoying. You'll see a lot more random nonsense of all kinds in the future. Forgot about why she asked for help for now. Let's take a look at how we may help her. Now, use this pen I just gave you. We can slice this letter into several pieces. Now see, some of these pieces are black and some of them are white. To prevent logical chaos, some of the pieces cannot be moved. These pieces are designated in black. Meanwhile, the white pieces can be moved anywhere, with one exception. No white pieces can go past the first or the last piece. Now that you understand the limitation of moving these pieces, you might feel free to move the white pieces around. After you rearrange the white pieces, these events will happen exactly as you want in the human world. If your rearrange has altered the previous causal links within the event, naturally the ending of the letter will be changed. Well, that's about it. What? Are you telling me I could change what has happened to the human by moving these sentences around? Exactly, isn't it straightforward? Oh gosh, that's so awesome. Can you do it too? Only the person who is holding the pen is capable of doing this. Go ahead, give it a try. Once you make your decision, just select OK. Okay, so she said that if she had... if the light didn't go out, she would have noticed that it was away, so only two options. So if I switch these, it should be okay. The alley was always very dark to begin with, and with the light gone, it had gone pitch black. I couldn't even see my hands in front of my face. I kept having a feeling that something was going to happen. Scenes from horror movies and homicide shows I'd seen suddenly flashed through my head. Don't watch scary movies when you go to dark places. Never turns out well. Since I was too scared, I turned around and picked another longer way home. The detour was a crowded and lively street. It was full of people hanging out and waiting in front of bars. And a lot of arcades were still open. I was planning to head straight home and go to bed. But I saw the latest version of stuffed Serp's body through the window of an arcade. Hey, there's some text highlighted in blue here. That means it's a term archived in her dictionary. The human letters often include some special terms related to their day-to-day lives. These terms will be highlighted. Since we are gods, there's nothing we don't understand. Therefore, wherever we encounter one of these strange terms, a definition for them will automatically appear in the dictionary. We may either press the pad to see the explanations for that specific term or browse all the archived terms in the dictionary. By the way, similar to the dictionary, we also keep a record of the profiles of everyone who has written to us. All you need to do is press X on the letter selection screen to read about them. Oh wow, being a god is so convenient. Serpotty, a cartoon cat character by British artist Kevin Clifford. It quickly became a global phenomenon because of its unique style and laser-sharp eyes. Its success lifted Clifford out of poverty and made him a worldwide sensation overnight. According to Kevin, the inspiration of the character came to him during a short trip. Looks cute. Unfortunately, it was not for sale. I had to get it out of a claw machine. Oh, well, there goes your knife. And I'm not very good at those. I spent almost all of the cash I had on me, but it didn't come close even once. Miss, we are about to close. Please check your belongings and don't leave anything behind. I lowered my head in disappointment. I noticed that there was a bottle of some kind of drink on the counter that had appeared out of nowhere. Perhaps somebody had forgotten it there. I picked it up and threw it in the trash on my way out. I got home and turned on the light. All of the boxes I had moved in 2 days ago were still lying all over the floor. Tomorrow. I'll unpack them tomorrow. I'm too exhausted now. At least the shower felt great. I got out of the shower, climbed into bed and immediately fell asleep. Good night. Oh, I got an achievement. Rank S. Look, because of what you did, now it's the ally that has a broken light bulb instead of the tennis court. Therefore, the girl would not have left her keys at the dark tennis court. Even though it was only a tiny change, you have indeed changed her fate. More importantly, you might have changed more than what we are seeing right now. The impact of this tiny event could last for a long time, maybe even influence her entire life. A chain reaction like this is called the butterfly effect in the human world. We still can't be certain of how big the impact to our future is going to be. But keep in mind that our power has a potentially dangerous side to it. We must never abuse it. I understand. Well, we are done with this letter. Let's go back and see if there are more. Okay, so we got the butterfly effect. Awesome. Now I know for sure that they said something beep was going to happen. Now I know for sure that shit will be so wrong. Being a god is so easy. Don't get too excited. You still have a lot to learn. I have fetched the letters for you up until now. From now on, you should be getting your own letters. I have placed the mailbox at the bottom left corner of the screen. If the flag is up by the mailbox, it means that there are new letters inside. Did you hear a sound like ding ding just now? That's the new letter notification. Whenever you hear it, that means some new letters have arrived. If you processed all of the letters at hand, go and check the mailbox. Got it. Pick up mail. New message, the last word. New message, roses and a doll. Okay, so new person or Lee Wen again? Yeah, let's do Lee Wen again. Sometimes you might see multiple messages from two or more people at the same time. Why do humans have so many problems? In cases like this, you have to read through both messages in one thread before we can start working on them. What are you doing? I'm trying to see how long I can hold my breath. I don't think I could finish two letters in one breath. It's just a metaphor. Well, what should I do to find the other letter after reading the first one? After reading one letter, you may press L or to open the next letter. Whenever you need to switch between the two letters, just use the next letter button to switch back and forth. Okay, I'll start now. The apartment building I had just moved into was quite old. It didn't have an elevator, so I had to climb the stairs every day. As usual, it was already past midnight when I got back from tennis practice. I noticed something at my door as soon as I walked onto the fourth floor hallway. Was that a bouquet of roses? And the Serp's body toy I had seen in the arcade a few days ago. I had a sudden sinking feeling of anxiety. I had been getting strange emails starting the day from yesterday. The day before yesterday. Okay, that makes more sense. This was the first one. I've been watching you for a long time. Write back to me. Oh my god, she got a stalker. At first, I thought maybe someone had sent it to the wrong address by accident. Or it could have been some random phishing email. I didn't pay any attention to it. But the next day, I received another one. Please write back to me. I still have no idea what those weird symbols mean. And whoever had written these emails seemed to think that we knew each other. My cell phone suddenly burst in my pocket. I had a new email. I clicked on the email app with a shaking finger. We shall finally meet soon. Yeah, you're dead, girl. You're dead. I couldn't understand those symbols at all, but the words in the middle. All of a sudden, I felt a chill down my back, as if I was being watched by someone or something. But my body had frozen and I didn't dare turn around. I looked into the reflection in the glass of the window in front of me, trying to see if there was anything behind me. There wasn't. I was just being paranoid. Still, I decided to go and spend the night at Jing's place, just in case. I walked towards the staircase, but then I heard it. Footsteps coming upstairs, closer and closer. Who could it be at this late hour? Could it be the one who had written those emails? I immediately turned around and ran back towards my apartment. But I lived alone. What if they broke in? He would force me into the corner, pull a chainsaw out from behind him and cut me to pieces. Girl, you really watch too much horror movies. Like, that shit bad for you, man. Oh god, no. I stopped at the door of my neighbor, room 414. I choose you. Help me. No matter how hard I knock, nothing happened. I tried not to cry so much that I wouldn't be hurt, but tears were already streaming down my face. Come down, Liwen. The footsteps stopped at the fourth floor and were now moving towards me. There was only one more corner between us. It was too late for me to hide in my own apartment now. I held my tennis racket up. I swung it down as hard as I could with my eyes closed when the person arrived at the corner. The person I had hit wobbled and fell down the stairs. It was Uncle Sun. He seemed to be just going around the building and picking up the trash. Uncle Sun was laying on the ground and he was not moving at all. Oh my god, what have I done? God, please help me. Please, please, Liwen. Damn, girl. That's what you get for watching a lot of horror movies. The last word. It had been 10 years. You haven't finished. No. It had been 10 years. I had been cursed since the incident. Every time I picked up my paintbrush, my mind would start tormenting me, wreaking havoc. For 10 years, I had been able to paint. I hadn't been able to paint anything. I was suffering and I deserved it. By now, I had spent all of my savings, yet I was still alive. A friend was kind enough to set me up with a teaching job at the high school, teaching the art class. I would start tomorrow. I wasn't particularly well paid, but for someone who had been living with a power, water or heat in his apartment, it was like a burning bit of charcoal in the middle of a blizzard. I was really grateful to my friend. Ironically, I had just bought myself some charcoal earlier today. I thought I might be able to leave something worthwhile to the world as a painter before I died. Yes, I wanted to make one of those final masterpieces. I set up my easel. 1 hour passed, 2 hours, 3 hours. I had to put down the brush. Even if I managed to paint something, how would it be different from all of the other garbage in this room? It would just be another piece of soulless trash, just like me. All trash. I poured the coal into a basin and put it on the bedroom floor. I put on my best clothes, I carefully made my bed, and I lit the coals. I tried the doorknob and realized that the door was not locked. I chuckled. That was careless of me. I double-checked all of the doors and windows, making sure that they had been locked and sealed. I couldn't take any chances. I lay down on my bed. All I could see was her face. Here I come, honey. Sorry for making you wait so long. God, I am ready. Please take me away. When Sharon? Sharon? Ah, just call him Wen. He said, when there is more than one letter, the white pieces can be moved left and right as well, in addition to up and down. Since it will impact the fate of both people, you must be careful when making your decision. Okay. God, I am ready. Please take me away. Tot 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 tot. What was that noise? I struggled to sit up in my bed. My head felt like it was going to explode. Damn it, just a little longer and God would have taken me. Whoever had made that noise, be it a burglar or a utility guy, I would never forgive them. Excuse me, sorry for the intrusion. I sneaked into my neighbor's apartment. It was completely dark inside and smelled funny. It was so hard to breathe in this apartment. I wonder who would live in such a place. I shut the door right behind me. I accidentally knocked over some jars that were shelved next to the door and they made some very loud noises. Still, nobody responded. I suppose there really wasn't anyone home. I looked out for the peephole while I held my breath. A thin, old, humpbacked man walked by the door with empty plastic bottles in his hand. It was just Uncle Sun, the manager. Phew. This one is easy too. As Shakespeare once said, security is mortal's chiefest enemy? Chiefest? I don't know what chiefest enemy means. Which could mean that overconfidence is man's greatest enemy. Shakespeare, he's one of the greatest writers in human history. Overconfidence is man's greatest enemy? Well, but I am no man. Okay, then do you know how to write this person's name in Chinese? Haha, wrong, it's written as... Yeah, I don't know Chinese. Okay, I get your point. It's only easy because you're just being... you are just getting started. You will see soon enough. What does this yellow star mean? When you see a yellow star, that means you have unlocked all of the possible endings of that particular event. Ooh, should I try to collect all of the yellow stars? Oh no, that won't be necessary. Our job is just to help the humans with their troubles. No matter how many times you try or how many endings we unlock, for the humans there is only one ending to each story that they will ever know. So it doesn't really matter whether or not you unlock all of the endings, but I'm a completionist. In that case, why is the star there for? Well, I know you're asking me, but to be honest, I don't really know. It's there because I'm a completionist. And I want all the stars. New message. Farewell. Why? Farewell. Somebody had ruined my plan. Damn it. I sat up and realized I could barely stand. The entire room was spinning. I felt so nauseated that I almost threw up. Just a little longer and I could have seen her again. The room was completely dark since I hadn't been able to pay my utility bill for a while. I lifted my foot and tried to take a step, but I tripped over my easel. The brushes and paints fell all over the place. I crouched down and slowly started to pick them up again. It took me a while, as I was so exhausted. I put out the fire and opened the window. I stumbled upon my flashlight and pressed the button. Boom! I heard a deafening explosion. Was that a gas explosion? Typical gas explosions are caused by the drastic expansion of volume caused by the heat and additional gas produced during the burning. The concentration of a particular combustible gas or vapor necessary to support its combustion in air must be within a range known as the flammable range for the gas or vapor. Not enough fuel if it's too low and not enough oxygen if it's too high. For instance, the flammable range of carbon monoxide is between 12% and 75%. Concentration of flammable gases in our daily lives are typically lower than the flammable range. However, coal burning or indoor gas leaks could still cause cause dangerous gas to reach that range. The presence of an ignition source would trigger the explosion immediately. Sources include candles, lighters, stoves, as well as possible sparks that are generated by electricity, such as turning on a flashlight, ringing off a bell, or opening a fridge. Common combustible gases include natural gas, methane and carbon monoxide. I thought I saw a slender figure of somebody fall down in the fire before I passed out. When I woke up, the doctor told me that there was a 17-year-old girl, old girl who had been sent to the hospital along with me. She hadn't made it. Fortunately, however, I was still alive. I had third-degree burns all over my body. I lost my right arm and I couldn't speak. I couldn't even do something as simple as ask what the girl's name was. God, why didn't you just kill me instead? When Sharon, oh God, I killed a person. I lifted my foot and tried to take a step, but it tripped over my easel. The porcelain paints were all over the place. I crouched down and slowly started to pick them up again. It took me a while as I was exhausted. I think I can just do it like this. Oh, well, that's bad. Like this then? Yeah, so it was what I thought at first. Who's there? I pressed the button on my flashlight in a hurry and the white light almost blinded me. Duh! I saw a shadow fall to the ground. I quickly turned my light towards the sound and saw that it was a girl that I had never met before. I checked to see if she was still breathing. She was. I remembered a school picnics during my junior high years. I had done the same thing to scare a girl in my class. She didn't faint, even though I had done it intentionally. Kids today are so weak. I carried the girl into my ventilated bedroom, laid her down on my bed and pulled a sheet over her. I went back into the living room and picked up my paintbrush. I tried to remember her panicking face when she saw me. I suddenly had a new feeling, a feeling that I could paint something special this time. And yet, I just fell asleep with the brush in my hand while leaning against the wall. Wow, that was so scary. I don't want to see anything else like that ever again. Well, if you do want to see it again, you can. Well, you're reading a letter, press plus button to review the entire letter again. I wonder though, why can't we see all of these images? Aren't we just reading the letters? Technically, we are not actually receiving handwritten letters from the humans. You could think of these letters as a manifestation of their will. That's why they include more than a text you are reading. Sometimes we'll receive the image of what they see or even how they feel. Wow, that's really amazing. How did you feel? Whew, everything felt so unreal. Am I really God? Have I always been living here? And has the sky outside always been so red? It's even snowing outside, the weather is so weird. I have no memories of any of this. Is any of this real? Of course, don't worry about it. Your memories will come back to you slowly. Anyway, don't you think this job is perfect for you? And it isn't too hard either, is it? That's true, it is more interesting than I thought. Well, it is interesting indeed. It is also rather serious. From now on, I won't repeat myself anymore. Some of my previous instructions can be found in the help menu. The content in the help menu will also grow as you learn more about your job. However, you might not be able to find anything you need in there. For instance, if you forget or didn't pay attention to what I've told you, you might never be able to hear it again, so the truly important information, as you see here, will be highlighted in orange text. Things in orange text are extremely important. When you see something in orange, you should slow down your reading and pay extra attention. Now, answer fast. Which of the following words were highlighted in orange and what I just said? Extremely important. Extremely important. See, I knew this was going to happen. You have to remember the importance of every word in orange text. As long as you pay attention to them, they will be very helpful in completing a task. In other words, if you don't, you are likely to get stuck in some of the more challenging tasks. We are going to restart the game now to teach you a lesson, so that you understand how serious I am. You forgot to save your progress. What a shame, you have to restart the game all over again. Not... I was just kidding, quick, say thank you because I just saved you. You effing dog. Slot 0 on the load page. At the bottom left corner is an autosave. Hey Kaya, good morning. It will take you back to the most recently autosaved data point. Well, that's all for now. We'll say goodbye for the moment. I hope I see you again soon. Thank you. All my foxes are cute. I'll be here waiting. How did you feel? Whew, everything felt so unreal. Am I really a god? Have I always been living here? And oh god. No, I'm not going to read that all again. Truly important information is orange. This time do it right. Truly important information, I think. Correct. The orange text may appear not only in my words, but also occasionally in the humans' letters as well. The humans' letters might include text in other colors too, such as yellow and blue. The yellow text highlights digital messages in text message or email, while the blue text highlights messages left in a fax or note. The orange text, however, emphasizes something else. I'll explain to you later when we see it. You won't remember it at all if I say too much right now. In the end, you just need to remember that orange text is extremely important. Now, to make sure that you didn't just make a lucky guess earlier, we are going to have another quiz. Which of the following phrases were highlighted in orange text in my previous dialogue and what is their correct order? I hate you, dog. Think that one? Oh. Hey, McStankface. Thank you for coming. Yeah, it's really early, but I have like someone visiting me in about an hour and friends over the rest of the day, and I just really, really wanted to like still stream even though my voice is like really shitty. Oh boy, I think it is the second one. Oh, thank God, I'm correct. Phew, thank goodness. It looks like you have truly mastered what I taught you so far. You are truly my master. A whole 2-day party. Like, we're starting today and we're ending tomorrow. Like, I got a lot of food. Like, I got pizza, I got meatballs, I got deep fried donut balls, or oliebollen, as we call it in Dutch. Like, a lot. I got Skittles and chips. Aside from the orange text in normal mode, you will also notice a lot of red text. If you read those words very carefully, you might find some clues that help you solve the puzzles. In normal mode, such clues will be highlighted in red. They might help you with your deductions. If you ever find yourself stuck in a puzzle with no idea how to proceed, pay special attention to the red text and you will surely be able to make progress. Alright, it seems like you should do just fine now. And I can take it easy too then. I believe as you go along with your tests, you will eventually make the right decisions. Besides, I can see that you have already made a choice. A choice? Yes, I told you at the beginning that handling the prayers from the humans is a job. However, whether to help them or not, and how exactly you want to change their fates, is completely up to you. Oh my god, I could kill them all. I see that you have chosen an S ending for all of them. That means you are choosing the path of absolute kindness. I didn't really have a choice because I had a bad one and I couldn't, like, do it. Well, they were asking me for help, so of course I should help them. What's the alternative? That I should torture them instead? Yes. Not necessarily. I just want to remind you that the path of an absolute kindness is not an easy one, especially when you receive letters from two different people. You will have to make the endings for both sides an S. Simply achieving an S ending for just one of them won't be good enough. In other words, you have to solve two people's problems at the same time. I see, well, I'm sure I can find a way. Okay then, by the way, I suppose you don't remember your own name either. Your name is Myth. Myth? You are a god who can manipulate people's fate through stories and puzzles. That's why they call you Myth. Myth and Will. You might not know this yet, but you are actually quite popular in the human world. Some of the urban legends that have been circulating are stories about you. Wow, I didn't know I was so impressive. Even though I seem to have forgotten a lot of things and I'm still adapting and trying to learn. I do feel like helping people, and that makes me happy. If I work very hard, could I possibly grant wishes to everyone in the world? Everyone? Well, you'll be buried by all of the letters first. However, if you try your best, you should be able to shape the world a little close to your liking, at the very least. Got it, I try my best. Well, from now on, let me know if you have any questions. After all, it's just the two of us here. Can help a cat. Well, it was actually very fluffy. Let me see what kind of letters we're getting today. No, we're not going to do them today. Because my throat is starting to hurt again, like crazy, and this game is very good, so I'm not going to, like, sacrifice a lot of quality. Oh, my voice. But really, thank you all for, like, coming, even though it was very short. I thought I could, like, go on longer.